Hi students, in this video I am going to explain experiment 3 of microcontroller and embedded system laboratory. The question is, write a program to find factorial of a number. So here we are going to find the factorial of number 4, that is 4 cross 3 cross 2 cross 1, which is nothing but 24 decimal and 18 hexadecimal value. So here I am going to just do a multiplication only. First I will multiply 4 and 3, with the result I will multiply 2, with the result I will multiply 1. Okay, so here I am going to do 3 multiplications. So the count is 4 here, and same way 2 register, first one to hold the count, another one to hold the first data. So here count is also 4 and the first data is also 4. Let's start the program. This is the first line, area, session name, memory, then type of memory is read only memory, then entry point, first instruction, 4, the count value I am moving to R0 register, then the same 4 I am moving to R1 register. So one register is used for holding the count, another register is used for holding the data. So R1 is counter register, R0 is holding the data. Here now it is first data. So after the first multiplication, every time we will store the result in R0 register only. Okay. Now I am decrementing the count using sub instruction, sub R1, R1, 1. Okay. So now first time 4 minus 1 is 3. So this is the loop. So in the next instruction, I will multiply the two data. Data 1 is available with R0 register, data 2 is available with R1 register. So now the instruction multiply, for multiply operand should be 3. The third operand R3 to hold the result of multiplication. So R0, R1, 4 and 3 are multiply, and the result is 12, that will be stored in R3 register. That I am moving to R0 register, because as I said, R0 is used for holding the data. Okay, so the 12 is moved to R0 register. Now I have to decide whether I have to repeat the loop or I should come out of the loop. For that I am using compare instruction. So here I am comparing R1 with 1, because I have to do only 3 multiplication. Count is 4, only 3 multiplication. Okay, so 4 minus 3 multiplication operation, 1. So that's what 1 is taken here. So compare R1, 1. Now R1 is 3. So first time I will compare 3 and 1. So next I will keep conditional branch instruction to decide to go back to fact or come out of the loop. So same branch instruction. Branch not equal. If both are not equal, I can jump back to fact loop. Okay. 3 and 1 we compared in the first loop. Both are not equal. So again I will go back to the loop. Okay, so now this time I am subtracting 3 minus 1. Now R1 is 2. Okay, then I will multiply R0 content is 12. With that, I am multiplying R1 content, which is nothing but 2. So this time multiplication is 12 and 2. So 24 is the result, that is moved from R3 to R0 register. R0 is 24, so this time I will compare 2 and 1, both are not equal, so again I will go back to the loop. So this time R1 is 1, so I will multiply R1, which is nothing but 1, and R0, which is nothing but 24. So 24 into 1, that is moved to R0 register. So now I will compare 1 and 1, both became equal, so I cannot go back to the loop, I should come out of the loop, so I can end the program. Stop, end. Okay, so the final result is available with 20, final result 24 is available with R0 register. Execution we can see. We'll go for the execution. Thank you.
Okay, now I opened the KL window. The first step is project, new microvision project. The desktop, I am creating a folder called fact. Inside the folder, I am giving file name fact. Next to vendor is NXP. You have to choose the NXP. Our ROM is LPC2148. Okay, yes. After that, file, new. So this is project window, this is editor window. Here you have to type your program. I am pasting the program. So after typing the program, I can save it. File, save. So this is my file name. I am saving with extension .asm because our file is, our program is assembly language program. Save. After saving it, we have to move our file name, file into the target. So click on this plus, right click on the source group, add existing files to source group. So my file is fact with the .asm and the file type is not C source, our file type is assembly source. Okay, I added the fact into the source group and I deleted the starter file. So after doing all this, I can save it and project build target. I am building the program for the error checking. Now I got zero errors and zero warnings. Now I can go for the debugging. So debugging. Okay. So this is our program. These are the registers available in user system mode. All the registers are zero now. Now we'll start executing the program. So now you can see the arrow is here, means the program counter. Program counter is here pointing here. First instruction is going to execute is move R0, 4. So we'll execute the program step by step. So we'll click on this. So in the first instruction, 4 move to R0 register, R0 content change to 4. Next instruction, R0 content moves to R1 register, so R1 becomes 4 now. R1 became 4 here. Now subtract, I am subtracting 1 from R1. So R1 is 4, 4 minus 1, it will become 3. So R1 become 3 now. So it became 3. Now I am comparing 3, 1. So compare instruction will not be stored anywhere. So no changes will be there in register content, only the PC value will change. So PC value is next time you can see. It is 10. So previously it was C, now it became 10, but comparison result it's not stored anywhere. Now I am multiplying. First time I will multiply 4 into 3. So that result we can see in R3 register. So R3 register is 0 now. For the next click it became C. Because when we multiply 4 into 3, it will become 12 decimal number. For that corresponding hexadecimal value is C. So C you can see here. Now I am moving this to R0, so R0 will become C. So one by one you can see everything here. For the last output, for we know that the result is 18, that result will be available with R3 register and R0 register. See, you can see here R3 became 18 and R0 is also became 18. So this is our result. R1 content previously it was 2. So see, you can see here R1 is 2 now, because in the last loop R1 will become 1, but that will not be stored anywhere. So the result is 1. See. Okay, see students, in the program we used 3 registers, R1, R3 and R0. So all the 3 content you can check here. We know that R3 and R0 are 18. You can see R3 and R0 are 18 and R1 is last time it will become 1. So last the 1 is in R1 register. So all the 3 register content you can check in register set. So this is the output for this program. Thank you.